The new handbook places great emphasis on proper preparation for conducting risk analysis. This approach recommends using the 5T methodology. Are you wondering what this is? I will explain it to you. In order for the FMEA analysis to bring about the intended results, we need to plan the whole project. For this purpose, the 5T checklist will be helpful here. The checklist includes the following questions. FMEA intent. Why do we conduct the FMEA analysis? FMEA timing. When should we do this? FMEA team. Who should be part of the team? FMEA task. What tasks should we do? FMEA tool. How to conduct the analysis? These questions must be answered before we set up FMEA teams and provide them with the tasks that we want completed. FMEA intent recommends that team members have the skills, knowledge, and competency to conduct the analysis, taking their role in the FMEA team into consideration. If the team members understand the nature and purpose of the analysis, they will also be able to achieve the objectives of the project. Now it's time to talk about FMEA timing. FMEA analysis is a tool used as a preventative tool, before the event occurs, not as an exercise when something has already happened. FMEA analysis is most valuable when it is used before a product or process is implemented. The FMEA team should be a multidisciplinary team. Its members should have the required knowledge in terms of both the FMEA methodology and the subject of analysis. The current FMEA analysis is a clearly understood method with the following 7-step approach. Step 1, FMEA scope definition. Step 2, structure analysis. Step 3, function analysis. Step 4, failure analysis. Step 5, risk analysis. Step 6, optimization. Step 7, results documentation. Do you see a fundamental difference from the previous handbook? Yes, you're right. Structure and function analysis has appeared, something that was not previously included in the AIAG handbook. It was, however, contained in the VDA approach. We will thoroughly discuss the details of the individual steps. Here is the last element of the 5T methodology, FMEA tool. A special program intended for this tool may turn out to be helpful in conducting the FMEA analysis. Nowadays, the market offers many opportunities. However, it is not necessary to purchase the software. The organization may also use a standard format and build its own database. What will the new approach bring us? Listen to this. The RPN elimination and its replacement with action priority. The tables of criteria for severity, occurrence, and detectability have changed. The FMEA worksheet has also changed. New columns appeared. The new approach, as you already know, introduces the 7 steps of the FMEA process. And be aware, there is something that didn't exist before, the FMEA MSR, FMEA for Monitoring and System Response, RPN, has been replaced with another factor. What was its purpose? Eliminating the risk priority number and replacing it with an action priority is intended to properly prioritize risks and prevent manipulation of the S, O, and D rates. S, severity, describes the failure mode. O, occurrence, indicates the frequency with which the cause of the error occurs. In addition, it reflects the effectiveness of preventive actions undertaken. D, detection, indicates the effectiveness of detection actions. The detection value is assigned considering the most effective detection action. Now it is time to provide you with an example to show the differences in the new and old approach. Imagine that we are car manufacturers. We assemble cars on our production lines and then sell them to end users. Let's assume that our employees sometimes forget to install the sound deadening mats. What will be the result of this terrible oversight? Excessive noise in the car cabin. If the noise in the car cabin exceeds the permissible levels, legal requirements will not be followed. In such a case, the severity of effect is at level 9. Let's also assume that our preventive measures are not effective enough to exclude the possibility of occurrence of a defect at 100%. So let's rate occurrence at 4 and detection at 2. Following the old approach, we would use the product method and determine the RPN rate. In our case, it would be 72. What does this mean? In the case of organizations that decided to implement an action only on the basis of the RPN value, this result means that no action needs to be implemented. In the previous episodes of this course, it was said that using RPN values should not be the only criterion for evaluating performance. I would like you to bear it in mind. The new approach, together with the action priority matrix for S, O, and D values, will oblige us to implement relevant action. According to the AP, the action priority will be high. How do we know that? Look at the part of the table that is provided by the handbook in order to prioritize actions in a correct manner. The table includes all combinations of severity, occurrence, and detection values with their respective priority. As you can see, if the severity value is 9 and the occurrence is 4 and the detection is 2, then the action priority is high. It is simple, isn't it? In the new approach, there are three types of action priority: high, medium, and low. Remember that in contrast to the risk priority number from the previous approach, the action priority is not an indicator of risk prioritization. The method presented is a method for prioritizing the actions necessary for risk reduction purposes. A high action priority means that the team must either identify appropriate actions to improve prevention and/or detection measures, or justify and record why current actions are adequate. A medium action priority means that the team should either identify appropriate actions to improve prevention and/or detection measures, or justify and record why current actions are adequate. A low action priority means that the team may identify appropriate actions to improve prevention and/or detection measures. However, note one thing. The handbook recommends that with a potential failure effect of a severity value of 9 or 10, with a high or medium action priority, we must, as a minimum, do a review, even if a decision has been made not to take any action. Now take a look at the presentation. Here you will find elements of the action priority tables. Try to read out the action priority with regard to severity, occurrence, and detection. Severity equals 9, occurrence equals 2, detection equals 1. Severity equals 8, occurrence equals 8, detection equals 8. Severity equals 4, occurrence equals 5, detection equals 2. Would you agree with me that rejecting a risk priority number and shifting into an action priority is a revolutionary idea with regard to the FMEA approach?